Hi everyone. So today I'm going to do a multi-ring pour using only two colors on a 20 by 24 canvas. These are the colors I'm using: Folk Art Metallic Pure Gold and the Fine Touch Acrylic in Mars Black. This is the pouring medium that I typically use. I haven't strayed away from that. So when I mix my paint, it's usually the Deco Art pouring medium and a little bit of water. So I'm gonna use four separate cups, but I'm going to incorporate two separate tilting techniques. So stay tuned. Okay, so I got my canvas primed, kind of painted the edges black. It's kind of getting on my nerves after I'm pouring. I like to use a lot of negative space. So I wanted to make sure that there was no white showing around my edges. So that's why I primed it first. So I got my cups layered, got black and gold alternating. And I got my base coat. I'm gonna lay down a base coat first. It's gonna be a little thinner than my cups, my layering cups. So I want that to, my cups to flow. Well, this black is gonna help my cups flow. My rings flow. All right, so I'm gonna lay my base coat first. Most of that. See if it's thin enough to, there we go. So I just wanna make sure I get an even base coat on here. Go ahead and turn this around so you guys can see. Also, I think spreading it this way helps me see if there are anything in my paint, which this is kind of, not sure what that is. Not sure what that was, but got rid of it. I think I got rid of it. I did not get rid of it. What is that? Oh. Okay. Go ahead and go out this way. I don't want too much of it going over the edge. Granted, it would be quicker to spread it with a spatula or palette knife, but just kind of want it a little smoother. So I think we're good there. I'll go ahead and torch the bubbles out. So what I'm gonna do my four cups. Do one cup here. Well, kind of equal from the corners. So go ahead and get started with my first one about here. I know some of you guys, or most of you guys, are probably right-handed. So to see me pouring left-handed, going in this direction, might feel or look a little weird to you guys. But y'all lefties out there will understand. So far, so good. When I layered my cups, I started with black first because I kind of like that dark in the center of the ring. And I end it with black. I didn't mean to do that. End it with black. So it'll flow a little better once the ring started coming out. If that makes sense. All right. And right up there. My Dixie cups are 9 ounces. So I poured, or layered, excuse me, about 6.5, 7 ounces in each cup. So I would have plenty for coverage. And also hopefully to maintain some of my negative space. I think what has helped me in doing my ring pours is making sure that consistency is all the same for all the colors I use, of course, rule number one. And to pour slowly. I know some of us get impatient as far as how we want all the paint out just to see and we get all excited. Having it come out a little slower, just taking your time, it's pretty good. It's helped me put that down a little bit. All right, about here. Rings are getting jiggly. Maybe I had too much coffee. I'm doing this one because I did a smaller version of this using 2 cups, 2 layered cups. And I liked how it came out. And I had a couple of folks ask for a video of it. Well, I recorded it initially, or thought I did. Once I was pouring my rings, after I poured my rings, I looked up and it was not recording. So much for that. But the after product was pretty good. The other one was a 16 by 16. This one is 20 by 24. So the big sister to the first one. Got the end to this cup. Oop. All right. I'll turn this. And for my last one. All right. things aren't even from the corners of the canvas, but that's okay. I don't know if you guys in here, I've got Rick James playing in the background. Got Pandora radio on. Listening to him's kind of reminding me of Buffalo. He's from Buffalo. I was born in Buffalo. Go Bills. I'll let my husband hear that because we live in Kansas City. So we're Chiefs fans. Okay, there's gonna be some tight rings. Nice, that gold is shimmering already. I love it. Almost caught it, but that's okay. Alright, so got my rings poured. Let me kind of move these cups out of the way. Go ahead and do some torching. Got a few cells popping up, which is fine. All right. So as I mentioned earlier, I'm going to do two different tilting methods. I'm gonna go corner to corner, and then I'm gonna swirl it. So let me put this back around here. I got the plastic under here because I was going to do another pour after this one and I didn't want it sitting in the drippings from this one. So, all right, so I'm going to go from corner to corner, that corner, back in the center, and then I'm going to swirl it around. I don't want to go too fast. I'm going to go back to the center. Back over in this corner. Just enough to the edge, back to the center, go over down this edge here, down this way, and go back this way. All right, I'm noticing that I did not, I don't think I laid down enough of my base coat. I see my edges of my rings pouring over itself, but that's okay. All right, and go back to the center here. All right, now I'm gonna tilt. Swirling around. Let's see, I'm gonna do, I'm gonna hold it like this. Yeah, just hold it like this. And just gonna swirl. Looking good so far. I don't think I'm liking this black in the middle right there. But it'll be all right, I guess. Trying to get a little bit more distortion in these bigger rings here. Ooh, that's one of my push pins. I think we're doing good. All right, in the end, I'll show you guys the smaller piece that inspired this bigger piece. All right, now I'm gonna get this dark spot in the middle here. Just kind of center it. All right. That's what we got. Oh, crap. All right, I got my edges around here that are bare. I primed them black, but I'm gonna go ahead and put a little bit of base coat around those edges. Not bad. There's no white showing through, so if I miss a spot as far as covering these edges, it'll be all right. You won't be able to see it. I'm just basically doing this so the paint will be a little more even on the edges. What we got. Let me know what you guys think. I'll go down a little bit this way. Just a little bit. All right, I'm gonna bring you down for a closer look. I do like how the gold is shimmering. Again, I don't know if I'm too crazy about this part here. I'm not going to mess with it. I'm not going to pour another ring in the center there. going to enjoy it as it is. Let me do another round of torching for good luck. All right, I'm gonna bring you down for a closer look. Okay, so here it is. My black and gold multi-ring pour. Rings are looking good. Got some good separation in some areas. Can't quite get that shimmer. A little bit here. So this is what happens when you start with black, when you're laying your cup. The center of your rings are a little darker and gets a little brighter as you go out. It's kind of the look I was going for. So here we go. I'll wait to see until it dries. All right, see you in a bit. Okay, so here is the inspiration piece for the one featured in this video. This is a 16 by 16 inch. I did the same thing basically as far as layering, started with the black and ended with the black. But this one has a little bit more distortion in my rings. Kind of like how that looks. And that going through there like so. Looks kind of good. I really like that. That's what I was basically going for, that distortion for the bigger one. Didn't quite work out, I think, but I think it still looks good. So we'll see how it dries and get it out and show it to you. Getting out in the sun. Thanks.